just over Atlantic Ocean. Please look at on the wind direction and the strength is a direction is at 249 degrees and the speed is 136 knots. So we have almost tailwind. So our ground speed now is 600 nautical miles per hour. So with a little bit turbulence because we are going within a quite heavy jet stream. Just past the middle of ocean and we are approaching to 653 north 20 west. There's a one of our point on the route. We can just prepare the approach procedure in the Baku airport. So first of all, we have to take the expected weather, especially the wind direction in Baku airport. It's via ACARS. And normally the first officer just do that. So I ask Samir, can you just take the weather from Baku? Yeah, Baku airport is not in the system data ATIS, digital ATIS. So we can't obtain the present terminal information. We can obtain only the weather. Okay, we have to wait a little bit. After a few seconds, the message information appears. So we obtain the message via ACARS. And now we have the weather together with the forecast in UBBB. There is a Baku airport. So the wind direction is 0606 knots. Okay, can you take the another page? Okay, the tempo is a CB, so it's a thunderstorm is expected. Anyway, wind is variable, but the main direction is from north. So we can just choose the runway for landing in Baku 35. We go on the CDU to choose the runway in Baku. So it's the ILS runway 35, and we expect the standard terminal arrival in some one hotel. It's choose. So just now it's done. So we can check the route on the navigation display. And of course, the route on the CDU. We have to compare it with Jepsen data. So if everything is okay, we can just confirm by execute. And also, we checking on the navigation display, comparing the points, which is done in the CDU. Step by step, is everything is okay, it should be just execute. It means there is a confirm. Just a moment, there is a whole route for the approach in Baku. Okay, can you execute? What we have to do to check the decision altitude in Baku on the runway 35. Well, that's runway 35, category 1 approach for D aircraft approach. I mean, because there's a due to the weight for landing, due to the speed for landing, which is connected with the weight. So the decision altitude is 198. You have to choose it on the panel. Okay, do that. And the decision altitude will appear here on the primary flight display as a barrow. It means that it's from barrow, barometrical altimeter, not radio altimeter. Radio altimeter is used only during approach for category 2. Category 2, when the base, the ceiling of clouds is not less than 100 feet and the visibility is not less than 300 meters. And we have to check what would be the speed approach on a flaps 30 in Baku? So Sami, can you do that? Okay. So we'll be 262, 265, let's say. Very light aircraft. We have not so much payload. Okay, 265 is so. And the computer calculated the speed, and speed is supposed to be 139 knots on the flaps 30. So it's a normal landing configuration, and we just set the flaps 139, so it will be our target speed during approach. Now is prepared for approach in Baku if the weather will not change significantly, and when you approach to Baku for the distance approximately 200 miles, which is the range of the VHF activity, we can check the information, present information for the time for landing in Baku, and if everything is the same, so we can just only confirm everything. And now is landing is expected at 0211 in Baku, so the distance to go there is 3221 nautical miles, and now the present time is 1952. We are in the middle of Atlantic, and anyway aircraft is prepared already for landing in Baku. So it's almost 11 hours in the air, and we are approaching to Baku. It's almost sunrise, so I think that we will be landing after sunrise. For the explanation, I'm today on the flight from Chicago to Baku. I was on the relief captain because I was on the real duty captain for takeoff and landing during the flight from Baku to Chicago. We are augmented crew, it means there's three people because the flight time is 11.5 hours, so there's according regulations. The two people can't do that, so we had to be the three guys. And landing captain now is Ivan Kandrac from Croatia. Igor, sorry. As Sami Valiev, the guy from Azerbaijan. Prepared for approach. The standard terminal arrival is established, and check the ILS frequency, and set the target speed for approach, and also decision of just get clearance for descending flight level 150, and we are flying on the level 390, and we are starting descent.
Exit, runway 34, new. Runway 35, new. Good. Braking action 70. Transition level 110. Bird migration. Wind runway 3.
The controller and approach. He gave us a little bit shortcut. We not follow just the setup route. So we are a little bit too high because the computer calculate a little bit longer route, so we have to expedite descending a little bit, as is not so much. At 10,000 feet, we have to reduce the speed to 250 knots. That is a procedure. We are on the intercept course to intercept the localizer. Final approach and the glide slope. The localizer mode and glide slope mode is armed on the white color. It means it's ready for intercepting. Localizer just was captured, so it means that we are aligned with the center line of the runway, and also in a moment the glide slope will be captured as well. Then disconnect the autopilot, now is a manually flying. So the weather is good, and in a moment we should be on the ground.
Approaching 3-5.
Fifty, 40, 30, 20, 10.
Located runway, and the aircraft is preparing for the normal taxiway procedure. It means that the guys had accomplished the after landing checklist, and now we are going to descend. And after 11 hours and 35 minutes flight time from Chicago to Baku.